Are there any changes to the agenda?
Item number six.
Yes.
I would like to request, if I may, second, to call a special call meeting Thursday morning. We need just about another day to get this tidied up. I think we're 98% home.
I think so too, and I'll second that, only I'd like to see it Thursday afternoon.
Let me check.
We can do that. We have a finance committee meeting?
Yeah, it's Thursday.
We 3 o'clock.
We do, sir.
We could do this 1:30 or 2. Or move the finance meeting.
Transportation and air quality committee meeting.
That's at 10.
At 10 a.m. What time are you calling for? 2?
I was going to say 2, we have time. We can move the finance to 4.
We have to do it pretty quickly, it's been advertised.
Can we just make it 2?
And we meet at 4.
Thursday at 2?
Let's meet at 2, and if we're not done, we'll adjourn recess to go into finance and come back out.
Okay.
We can do that, right?
And then we can recess finance.
Okay. Yes.
And come back to work session and go back
still
to finance.
Still all kinds of recess. My favorite part.
I love recess.
I'm going to be back here by 2.
You can just give me a proxy out there.
Oh, you go downtown?
No.
Oh. I'll just have to be back here by 2, if that's what we decide to do.
So
we
motion
have
is to postpone and call for a special call work session on Thursday, 2 p.m.
April 12th.
Regarding water.
Item number six.
Mr. Chairman, we
I'll
have
tell you what. You want to do it? I'll make it. We'll do it.
We need to recess this one.
We'll ask them to get it.
It's not.
Hold on. We might have.
I mean, if we want to get in a bidding war.
We're getting close. Don't get condescending.
If we're getting in a bidding war, that makes sense.
Let me interrupt.
5 years.
Council,
please tell us. 5 year option. There's a motion on the floor.
There's a motion on the floor for discussion.
But a motion to recess will trump that.
We're in the middle.
How about if we vote on this one?
Let's just vote on it and be done with this and then recess.
Okay, just be mindful, you've got an advertised finance committee meeting at 3 o'clock. But
why would you do that knowing what we're doing today?
I didn't schedule it. I'm just telling you.
It's already advertised.
Motion to recess this meeting so that we can enter into a finance committee meeting.
And then come back to this?
Immediately come back.
Immediately.
Immediately come back.
Is that a second?
That's a second. Because I don't want to vote on half of this and then not finish it.
We'll come back to that.
Of course.
We have a motion and a second to recess this so that we can have the finance committee meeting. If there's no further discussion.
Let's discuss it for a while.
Have you discussed it or not?
Thank you.
Happy?
No, but I'm good.
Please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign.
Need to call the finance committee meeting to order and then an immediate motion to recess.
Okay. I call the Forsyth County Finance Committee meeting to order. Can I hear a motion?
Second.
We have a motion and a second. I second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes.
Thank you. Y'all are back in session.
That goes. Ding, ding.
Yeah. Good Lord.
Are they taking up 3? Are they going to take up
3? Hold on. Yes,
Tony.
I gave you that just so you know that, don't you?
Come on, Todd.
Are we back in session?
Yes, we're back in session.
Not quite yet.
So at 3 o'clock, they recess their meetings. Open the meeting recess.
Right. Yes.
I just need a few more minutes. We'll finish up the letter. We'll look at it.
I'm here when you're ready.
Okay. All right.
The whole meeting will just wait. Wait a second, you're eating something.
A couple hours. I had to. Who's your agenda?
Yeah, where's your agenda? Here it is.
Make some copies?
Yeah, I'll make some.
Are you staying here with me?
With us?
Oh, this is zoned out there a little bit. You really want more of this, huh?
Okay. I'm just glad to switch gears and we talk about something different.
We got some proposals going across the street. Let's see how that goes.
Yeah, there's only so many different ways you write on that. Something different is... Next paragraph.
Do you want me to move the ones that are out there? Because there's the old agenda.
Who's your other reporters?
Jennifer and Crystal. Julie, what about her?
Well, Julie was here. No, Julie was here.
Julie's gone now.
And Julie's gone.
Okay.
That was Arrington. She's gone. Hmm. Who did you send her?
Send her. Well, maybe I did send her somewhere.
Where did she go?
To Alabama.
Oh, yeah, it's back closer to home.
Yeah.
But you're still here.
I know.
There's some guy or something somewhere right here, right?
Oh, yeah.
You put a lot of your...
I brought him in here.
So you're not going to go somewhere, because he's here.
I'm going to go get that, my budget manual, because okay. I didn't bring it.
Okay, so my other choices were Crystal or Jennifer.
Crystal's really tall, and Jennifer's really short and has curly hair.
Probably was Jennifer's
short. Yeah. I don't
remember. Jennifer
and Julie are both short. Yeah, it was both short. In fact, I got confused.
We said now that
one that was on average, the other one.
We said now that Julie's gone, the average newsroom height has increased.
Yeah. Why did you do all the snowboarding?
We got to start this meeting.
Yeah, if you're on
time.
Yeah,
we're starting
this mile. I went to the beach last weekend.
City? Yeah. City School Beach.
What?
How'd you like those animals?
What are you still doing here?
Fun.
Open those blinds.
I have no idea.
No. We need to contract with Nydia. As an independent contractor, the meeting compliance officer for the county.
That's right. Then?
And I'll bring the eye that never blinks.
That thing will make you look fatter, though.
I know, she's making me look fat.
I don't think she stretches.
Get the skinny lens out for that thing.
Mm-hmm. She gets the one that for the like the funhouse mirror for me.
Oh, no.
You're fun already. You don't need it.
That's me.
Okay.
How are you, sir?
Good. How are you, sir?
Good.
Good.
She went to get a budget manual?
Oh,
yeah. It's a nice laptop. Do you know how big and clunky mine is when I try to take it home?
I know, I hate that for you.
IT can go down and get it every time. I used to have
ordered some carbon paper.
Did you get that? Paper. No, Pete got a printer. Pop got a printer. I got mine taken away.
All right, Dave, ready to start?
We're good to go?
Yes, sir.
We're called back at a recess at 4:22 on the clock, that one. Where I'd like to start is to help with a brief calendar update of where we're at and what we're going to work on next and where we have a few items, maybe three areas to cover,
where some guidance will be helpful as we put this together. Just for a quick budget calendar update and the near-term portion of the calendar, as of this last Friday was the department office's deadline to submit their budgets, and they're still coming in, so we're working on starting to get them all into the system. What we have to get those all compiled for in particular is for the departments and offices next month in May, which I guess would be the second week from May 7th to 11th is when the county manager meets all accounting departments over their budgets. So we'll be doing an intense review then, line by line. The week after that, May 14th, 18th, is when we've scheduled for the elected officials to come in and meet with, that will actually be with the finance committee. So that'll be all, hopefully be able on your calendars to meet with those particular budgets. All that will lead up to the initial date for the board as a whole will be June 12th, where at that work session we do the preliminary budget presentation. So to help us get there, what's next? And basically going back now to April and May, what is next is compiling this preliminary budget. And what we're looking for today is to get for some guidance, some directional answers, if you can help us with that, which will give us some basically assumptions that we'll compile the preliminary budget based on. It doesn't mean they're carved in stone, things can't be changed, but if we get an idea of which way we might go for compiling this budget, that will help us making any maybe unexpected turns later, which would take some effort to readjust. So that being said, there's particularly three areas. One might be could be a broader area. One that three we want to discuss, and particularly the first one will help us a lot if we can get some direction on this. The first area is the internal service funds, which I'll leave for those present as well, briefly describe what those are. For certain central services, if you will, things such as finance, payroll, HR, IT, that are provided for the entire organization. For a number of those, they have been moved into separate funds from which all of their services are charged out or allocated to all of the areas of the county budget. That's how that works. So the money flows, if you will, from all the other funds, general fund, water, sewer, into these internal service funds who provide those services to at the areas of the county. Some have asked why is it done, why is it set up in the first place. The main purpose of that, I think, in different governments that do this in different ways to different extents, is to show the cost of services for the various county department offices. So when a service is provided like IT, it charges them a portion for those services. You do not have to do it that way, but that is a choice that governments make for certain services one way or the other. When I came here and a couple years before, when the county manager was here and looking at those, we'd already started to change some of those away from internal service funds. A couple that are no longer there are employee health care cost and employee pension cost. Right now, we have remaining seven areas that are separate internal service funds. And not only are they separate funds, it also means there's a separate accounting for them. And when you account for them separately, they have different accounting rules. It starts to get cumbersome, and any benefit gained from doing this begins to be lost as far as the cost of doing this is concerned. The seven areas we have, and we'll have a recommendation to continue on the path of going away from these that we've started, is the seven are, one is the administration fund, which includes those areas such as finance, payroll, human services, procurement, and communications. Those are all in that one fund. Second fund, there's a public building fund, where the cost of facilities is allocated out to everyone based on their usage of facilities. We have a fleet maintenance fund, which is pretty self-explanatory. An information services fund where all the IT costs are centralized and then allocated out. A GIS fund, and then two insurance areas, a workers' comp fund and a risk management fund. And what we'd like for this committee to consider, looking for input if we could, is to recommend eliminating or moving away from some more of those funds. In particular, I'll just give you my recommendation. This relates to four of them in particular. First of all, there's two I think should always be internal service funds. They're the most common ones you'll see in governments separately, and that is the two insurance areas, workers' comp, risk management. They have their own reserves, they're accounted for separately, and that works best to put them in a separate fund from the general fund or any other fund. So those two I think probably always stay separate as internal service funds. Fleet maintenance fund is another common one that you will see in governments, and can still function very well as internal service fund. They have their own inventories, their own building equipment. We may change methods instead of allocating out. If we keep a fleet maintenance fund, we might charge based on per repair,
an actual cost to repair. That might work better for that. The four I'd like to focus on today and get some feedback on, and I'll give you these in order. If we were to only eliminate one this year, not try to do all four at once, which we certainly can do all four, I would recommend that we eliminate the public buildings internal service fund, and I'll explain how we do this and how it would work. The others, I think, which should be candidates for eliminating is internal service fund would be the administration fund, the information services fund, and then the GIS fund. So those four we'd like to focus on, whether we do, if we do any at all, whether we do one or two this year, all four of them, or we do some the following year. Now, basically how this would work, and here's the impact is important, is most of these services you would normally find, if it's not internal service fund, you'll find it in a general fund of accounting because they're general services. What we would do is to move a service such as facilities back into the general fund. So in the general fund, you'll now see the public facilities department in the general fund instead of a separate fund. What they'll do is that'll eliminate the need to charge things within the general fund. So all those charges to general fund departments for facilities will go away. And in place of that, that department would be in there. To keep this with a revenue neutral, if you will, impact with no impact on the general fund, we would still continue to charge out to the other funds, other revenue sources for facilities such as fire and fleet, fire and water and solid waste, 911, and so on. The benefit there is the savings, particularly in that public buildings fund, is the time we use to separate a separate fund, account for it, make entries. It's just, there's a lot. Even setting this up, I had to smile the other day, we that all departments check on their square footage. That's one of the factors we base this on. And one department was debating whether or not they had 3,000 square feet or not. It was a 2,500 or 30. We had several departments in a line of emails saying, hey, what's the common area? What's the, it just, we got to the point that it's why do we continue doing that when there's real no benefit to doing that? And then that's why we would request any put on that. And that's the recommendation.
What about constitutional officers that have their own facilities, will that be in their budget?
By moving that back to the general fund, it would no longer show in their budget.
Well, I think it's when you look at constitutional officers who want to have the control of their funds, if they're in a facility, 100% in a facility, we're leasing, for example, I think that needs to be charged to their department.
Right. In the case of a lease, we could certainly decide to still show the lease cost there because we do charge those leases back in particular.
I think
beyond that, it's public buildings we own that we provide for everyone. But the lease facilities is a good point.
I think
point
that we should perhaps consider shared facilities would be, you would track those shared facilities. But if it's a dedicated facility for that department or agency or constitutional office, I think that you know, from a tracking standpoint, mm-hmm. Park and Rec, for example, you know, they've got all their different facilities.
Right.
The sheriff's office has all their facilities. Coroner has his place. You see what I mean? If
sure.
It's a shared facility, like
right.
Here in this building where there's many departments all using, yeah, I would say that that's just kind of a common facility.
And if we chose certain departments like that within the general fund, we could still do that within the general fund without having an internal service fund. We could certainly show the
you
charge here and put it back to the department.
Exactly.
Back in the county I came from where we had internal service charges, we called them central service charges, we didn't create a separate fund. We were in the general fund.
It's
we
just
showed the, we showed the revenue to our department, the charges of the other departments, and other funds.
Yeah.
We didn't create a separate fund. You don't. That's not a requirement.
That's
so
point.
We could still pick ones
yes.
We want to.
I think if they're in a facility that those costs attributed to that facility, if they're 100% need to be in their budget, we might not have it as an internal service.
Right.
But it does need, I think, to be.
We can still show the code. What we do is where PUF facilities would be department general fund.
The sheriff's office.
They would show
a headquarters building.
Yeah.
Then the cost
right.
To maintain and operate that facility needs to be shown in his budget.
Right.
The heating and air, the repairs and maintenance.
Right. And would change the general fund of just allocate
exactly.
The cost.
Just allocates the cost.
So the
but
facilities,
we don't have that fund.
Yeah, the facilities could have a transfer in line for, say, just say, even say sheriff's facilities over the sheriff's budget. If that's the way the board wants to go, the sheriff's budget would show facilities cost.
Right, and I'm not picking on the sheriff here. I'm just
saying, that just looks,
you know, any department that has 100% utilization
yeah.
Of a facility that is dedicated to their.
Well, let's use parks for an example. If in fact you do that, and Parks Department has access then to those funds, mm-hmm. and they could use them or attempt to use them for other things?
No, because they're not a constitutional
officer.
We would
not allow transfers out of those lines.
But others but that are constitutional officers could, would then have access to those funds?
No, because it's an allocation of expense. I guess he could say, County, I don't want you to pay the rent on this building. I'm going to get my own building. Okay, fine.
So we can still do that measurement focus within the general fund.
How do we create, and you might need to check with legal, it's that fine line between do they control those funds? Constitutional officers. We talked about before though, do we have to say that we allocate $110,000 a year to you for this building? Now, if you want to have that $110,000 and go find somewhere else to work out of, you can. Or, you see what I mean? We have to address that at some point.
Would that maybe be in an IGA then?
I think anything, and I think any constitutional officer that's using any, especially constitutional officers that are using IT and all those, I think there does have to be an IGA.
Yeah, and it would need to apply, I think you already said it, to a dedicated building, not a common use.
Well, I'm just talking about, yeah.
Because if the department moved out of a dedicated building, then you could sell it or use it, dispose of whatever you want to do.
Cancel
but
the
for common buildings, if someone moved out and took the budget money with them, you're not saving anything.
Common bill. I'm talking about if it's a specific use facility and however you want to allocate it. But that's right. In those instances, we certainly don't want and could not say that they can just move that money from facilities budget in their budget to hire more employees or something.
Well, they may decide that they have a standalone building that houses 12 employees, then in fact they need that money elsewhere, and they decide that those 12 employees can be relocated to other areas and buildings that they pay for, and then it frees up $80,000 a year at least.
If we get rid of that building, that constitutional officer, I think, by law, would have that right.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I think some of the other things we have to address, I know we're getting maybe a little bit off topic, but some of them are IT and personnel. If we're providing personnel services for constitutional officers, mm-hmm. We've had it in some cases where they don't necessarily want to follow all of the policies that we have for our general county employees. And they say we're a constitutional officer, we can do what we want, but it doesn't fit within the system that we have for general, for the other employees of the county. So we have to address that somehow too. That if they're going to use the service that we're providing, they have to use it as it's provided. I know that's getting way off what you're talking about, Dave, but historically we've got to figure out how to address that. If you're going to use county IT infrastructure, you have to use it under county IT infrastructure policy, retention policies, appropriate usage, all sure. of those things have to fall under because we're responsible mm-hmm. for what happens on that system. Mm-hmm. If they don't want to use our servers and they don't want to use our infrastructure, we'll take that out of their budget. We can give them the funds and then create their own.
That's okay. In general, I mean, you understand the concept because we've done it the last couple of years.
I know where you're going, and I'm okay with what you're talking about, reducing down tracking light bulbs and paint and everything for common buildings. No, we don't need to do that. But I don't want to go as far as to just roll all facility cost into the general fund, especially for constitutional officers. We have to, and if we got departments that are sole users of a facility, it has to be allocated in there somehow.
Do you think maybe then for this budget year, we look at the others, admin, and some of the others? That one, the public facilities, may have been the first one on your priority list, but in fact, is that going to be one that's going to take some?
GIS is a good candidate for we have a staff and they provide the products and everybody's using them, but they can't get it anywhere else.
Right.
You can't buy county GIS products from Staples. Those I can see rolling in. Admin is one of them.
So GIS and admin. An admin includes finance, procurement, personnel service, communications, and payroll.
In the mail room.
I agree.
Mail room.
Okay.
However, how do we ensure personnel's concerns that they've had over the years that constitutional officers don't want to follow the policies and procedures that they have set up for payroll reporting and all of those things. How do we?
This change in accounting, I don't think we'll change any of that.
This is just a change in accounting. We need to change it, is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
We need to get them to comply where they have not complied in the past. And that goes to the whole authority of a constitutional officer being able to control those funds. They can choose to use our admin, which is payroll and personnel and everything, but when they choose to use it, they have to choose to use it under the general policies and procedures that a department has to, or they can have those dollars and get their own payroll departments and their own personnel departments, and which they're allowed. It also answers the question that we can't be challenged on controlling funds for constitutional.
And whether those internal service funds were eliminated before, where health care came back away from internal service fund and pension costs, they're still charged to all those areas. So they're still paying for their
It's still
care, still pension.
Yeah.
It's still part of the program. And that's Commissioner Tam, any direction or what you think as far as removing these internal service funds are concerned?
No.
You're comfortable if we move it? If we
I don't care if we eliminate all of the internal service funds. However,
that's just one less
feel it's best to
headache.
Right.
You know, at what level do we need to
do it? Been a headache.
I'm comfortable with what finance wants to
point fingers
as long as we have the ability to monitor those costs and that we have the ability to charge them out appropriately. Maybe not an internal service fund, but through budget allocations. But I think we need to have perhaps some other discussions about the constitutional officers' budgets and what is in their budgets and how is it put in there and what control do they have. You know, they will say that we're forcing them to pay IT and this and that and the other thing, and they don't control those dollars.
Right.
Well, we need to give them the ability to make the decision. It makes sense for them to use county IT, it's cheaper, but they don't have to. But they also, when they're doing their budget, like now for 2013, they have to decide are they going to use it for 2013. And it's a contract, basically, an IGA through their agency and ours that they're going to use it. So that way we don't have employees that we've hired to meet their needs, and they say halfway through the year, well, we don't want to use it anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Which they wouldn't do, but they need to.
Okay, so you'd be supportive of, even with public buildings, if we move one or all four of those, but considering what do we still allocate to those areas?
Absolutely. I'm comfortable with whatever you recommend as far as
service funds. Whatever makes you more efficient, streamlines
I'm okay
your department, as long as we can answer questions and have information if we need it. And as far as some of these charges.
And Amanda, we've worked together. This is our fourth year now, I think. And you know what I mean when I say allocation of sole source buildings or sole purpose buildings, sole purpose software, sole purpose computers, all that stuff. I just don't want to throw into the general fund.
Mm-hmm.
We have to be able to allocate those out and give them the choice to say yes or no. We don't want to use those county services. Right. We want to hire them.
Okay.
Just so this committee knows, what will the end result be? For instance, if in fact there's a department with a budget today of $2 million, and part of that budget, $500,000 of it, is internal service charges, will they see a reduction then in their budget this year to $1.5 million, and that $500,000 will show up in all these other funds?
Well, that, yes, those, in the general fund, those departments' costs will go down in the general fund.
Right.
That cost moves over to the internal service fund department that we also put in the general fund, so it offsets, there's no impact there.
Right.
What we will continue to do is to allocate the cost out to other funds that have been paying, because that's different funding sources, they'll still pay the general fund. It does too, as far as total budget's concerned, to the extent that those other funds are paying then in the general fund and not the internal service fund, the total general fund budget will look a little higher, but we'll be able to isolate you why. However, the total county budget of $193 million, that internal service fund will be gone, which was just charges between funds. So that brings the total county budget down, because you're not double counting something going back and forth.
I understand, but that departmental budget could see a reduction of 15%. And so my budget went down 15% this year because of these changes. I just want to make sure y'all understand that.
But the cost of the county did not go down. Their cost moved somewhere else in general fund.
Right, right.
But we could still put things like leases into their budget.
Certainly.
But again, like you said, should there be an IGA so they don't take those funds, like you said, and use them for other things?
They have to commit it for the budget year. I mean, they can't say that we're going to have $250,000 or $300,000 for, like, sheriff's office, $700,000 in fleet. And then in March, we get upset and say, listen, we don't use that fleet. Give me my $300,000 or $700,000.
We can still choose for any department or office if we want to show the cost of something because they have their own facilities or their own computers or whatever. We can still show that there, and they transfer that cost over to this department that we've moved in general fund. Doesn't stop us from doing it. Let me add as well, whether we use the budget to do that or not, as we begin costing out our services, which we're going to have to be doing here, we will still take those factors into consideration. What is the cost of a park? What is the cost of, they do have utilities and they do have overhead. We can still calculate that out.
Yeah.
Whether we show it in the budget or not, it's part of their cost.
Yeah.
Because you have a departmental budget, but the cost of the services is much more specific.
I think more important than what I'm, Brian, however you guys feel is best, to, whether it's a fund or whether it's just budgeted, makes no difference, whatever you feel is best. I mean, that's your okay. We've talked about trying to reduce the red tape or whatever.
This will streamline.
Yes, to account for that separately, I don't think serves a really good purpose.
There's a lot of
by bringing it back in. But we can certainly not, I'll rely on Doug maybe to check with the commissioners if we bring facilities in, are there any particular departments or offices we feel, because they have dedicated facilities, where we should show their costs in the budget separately? We can still do it within general fund.
That should be the threshold. Okay. At some point, maybe the threshold is 75% of a facility, you know, they need to be 80% or something, maybe it's 100%, I don't know. So just as simple as that.
And maybe the method could be different. See, we take all the facilities budget now and we allocate it out based on the method. And it's hard to come up with a good method. We use square footage and work orders right now. Well, not all work orders are created equal.
Right.
When we did that, the parks number jumped way up. It may be that if we want to put a facilities cost for dedicated parks, we might set it up so that we will literally bill them for actual work orders. So it'll be the real cost to them.
If we want to get, again, that gets into a lot of,
depending on what we want to show.
As simple as, and again, I'll just use the sheriff's office because they're really ones that have their own facility. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure that we want to charge for one of our employees that is up there changing light bulbs in their office and doing that routine type of maintenance.
Yeah.
But if they go have a new air conditioning unit put in, or the light bill, this water sewer bill, the rent, supplies, you know, for buying paint, wallpaper, carpet, things of that nature would be allocated to them. And certainly, I don't know if we want to get into it. I think you're trying to simplify it to get away from having to allocate the staff and the staff's comp time and the staff.
Right.
No, I'm talking more about real expenses that we're paying, utility bills, rent, insurance on the facility. You know, if somebody drives through the door and, you know, in a garage somewhere, you know, and it's a real.
I think one test is it something that we're providing that they could just as easily have someone on the outside provide? Is it a service we're doing internally instead of externally? That's a good test, because I think in the area of facilities, we'll want to check in general, because it may get to this point, the responsibility of the county to provide facilities for various functions. Okay. And they're under Georgia code, so we'll make sure of that too.
But, you know, if they decide they want new carpet in their offices, and they want to paint it, to freshen it up.
That's the cost you could show there.
Yes, there.
Well, and we kind of do that now. We do that now. For instance, if the courts want to install new carpet in 2013, they submit that now, and it shows
so
up.
So we put it
in
there.
That's the way it ought to be.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. But okay. So as long as we don't lose that element.
Say during the year they decide that they've got some extra funds and they want to paint the courtroom.
Right. Okay.
That comes
very
out
good.
Of their budget, okay. Or if they have to hire painters to do it. That comes out of there.
Well, we actually went through that recently. There was something the courts wanted that wasn't budgeted, and they picked it up out of there.
Yeah, thank you.
That's good. So if we bring the facilities in, we can certainly do that separate.
Okay.
All right, the second one is a little bit new, but I think it's going to be a very important area. and this involves a capital projects fund budget. We are not required by state law to budget for a capital projects fund. We're required to do the general fund, revenue funds, debt service, and I believe that we're actually required to do enterprise funds, but we choose to do enterprise funds. Capital project fund, we can certainly have a budget for separately. Now, in particular, we have certain special purpose project funds, but counties that do this, governments that do this, obviously they have a funding source to budget there. And they have various funding sources. They can dedicate a revenue, some of them take a part of their property tax, put it in a capital project fund for, you know, future needs and so on. If we were to budget for a capital project fund, the one recommendation I guess I'd put there for the commission as a whole to consider as well would be, and it's good to have a funded, of course, capital project fund as facility needs come up. It's something we probably have a need for. And when I first came here, I was used to having that when I came before. What I would probably have the commission consider looking at is in the general fund, once we have met in our fund balance our 25% reserve, I think it could be an opportunity there for any excess above that or some portion of that excess, whatever the commission decided. Once we've closed the books, as we're going to do here shortly, any amount above the 25% reserve, the commission could, by resolution, by some formal action, say, transfer that to the capital projects fund. Then, with normal budget process, facility needs, capital equipment needs, and so on, we could establish a budget for that fund. So we wanted to see if that's something there is an interest from commissioners in this committee. Let's say, for example, this year we had, just pick a random, we had $1 million above our 25% requirement or goal in the general fund, and the commission through a mechanism such as a resolution would say, okay, that million is an additional to what is needed here. That gets moved to the capital projects fund, and then we would budget for that through the budget process, through the board to use it for. That's the concept.
What
or, a portion of
the
amount that's over
what
the
25%. Debt reduction?
The general fund amount?
If there's excess.
Well, general fund is pretty open to, I think, any legal purpose that the government could use for that debt. You could certainly put out the debt. Much of it being in water and sewer, but.
Do you not have more flexibility if you put it into contingency?
It's basically in there
now.
You have
some in the I guess
the 25% is really.
Let's just say we have a situation.
Let's go ahead.
The road broke on Ronald Reagan, okay? And we had to spend a lot of money repairing the water lines, that sort of thing. We had emergency repairs, we came out of pocket a lot. If that money is in the capital budget or something like that,
it wants it put in there.
Can we get it back out
need it? You have the ability to back the general fund.
It's
a general capital projects fund. It's not a special revenue. It's
okay.
General dollars.
It's not identified and
you can move it back.
Okay.
That's right. With simple as a resolution.
You would just budget a resolution.
We need it.
And
we
back.
Can get it. Yeah. That's all I want to make sure.
Kind of like a resolution.
Yes. Yeah. Board action. It doesn't. Yes.
Say we run out of water. Say we run out of water and we have to go buy water from somebody else. Nydia, can you hear me?
I sure can.
Okay,
yes,
and we need to run a water line or something like that. We can get that money to do.
See,
that.
A lot of things you need to end up doing are capital. If you had to run a water line, that's a capital project.
Okay.
So you can certainly allocate it right in the capital project fund. A lot of the large dollar needs that come up are capital items. It's not a whole lot of things you spend all on. Above $1 million, they're not a capital item.
Yeah, because you wouldn't want to move it in for an expense item that you got to have recurring.
That's the idea is the one-time things, because what you don't want to do with a fund balance that may be available in general fund is spend it on regular operations, because that's a dangerous road to go down. So capital project fund sets that aside for those kinds of purposes.
Laptops, printing.
And Dave, a capital projects fund would be something that would come through at the same time with the rest of the budget, and would be an open process, discussed, and
exactly.
The commissioners would decide if they wanted to fund it at all and to what level they wanted
exactly.
to fund it.
Right.
So it's
and it would only be dollars in hand because we would have closed the books by the time the budget process gets to that
like
point.
It's almost like a sweep account.
It's taking dollars available from the general fund, one-time dollars, not recurring
right.
revenue, putting
right.
in the capital project fund.
Where does impact fees and stuff go? Do they go into capital projects?
They have their own funds.
They're
impact. They are a
capital
project fund.
Yeah, they have their own funds, their own fund balance.
That's basically the concept. If there's interest in that, we'll bring that forward in the budget process. The only thing we would, I think, want more input in is what, to what extent of what kind of, above that 25% level, what interest is there in putting how much revenue over into the capital projects. So,
we'll come up with a recommendation if you like us to on that. Yeah, I think that would be helpful. Okay. All right.
Okay. Very good.
You know what I mean when I talk about the other agencies and offices. We've talked about that for years. You know what I mean.
Yes.
Okay. All right. I think that'll help to accommodate some needs. Third area. Sorry. Ready?
Go ahead.
This one is not as good news from last year. It's going to be difficult budget-wise this year. And actually, it's a broader area, which you may want to have input in general. But this relates to personnel costs. Specifically, I'll start it with, and we'll leave the other open, but health insurance costs. The good year we had in 2010 on claims was we're self-insured up to a cap. We more than made up for last year in 2011. We did have a lot of heavy claims. We had at least five claims hit the $175,000 level. And overall, the increase I calculated, because 2010 went down, 11 came up, and we'll check these numbers again later, but I did this for the bond rating phone calls we had. So look at it, we had over a 20% increase of what our actual claims cost was from 10 to 11. Something we have to deal with. There's a couple of things I'd like to bring up, and just we'll show you what we're already starting to work on, and looking at the kinds of claims that are in there, is we really, and our new consultants, Northwestern Benefits, who are working with us, they have specialists on, we're working on a more robust wellness program. I mean, which includes a lot of things, not just one element, but a robust wellness program. That can give you the benefits of reducing this cost. You have healthier employees, I think more satisfied employees that are pleased with themselves and so on. So we're already working on that. But other than that, one thing I want to talk about is if the board might be interested in getting to the point where we have a policy as far as the cost sharing is concerned in these increasing health care, well, when it comes to budget time. These tend to go three ways in a company or an organization. By the way, right now where we're at, of course, we know that it's a good benefit here. Right now, if I get the number, about 91% of the healthcare costs are paid for by our budget, by the county. 9% is paid for by the employees through their contributions, dependent contributions. As costs go up, three things, companies and other organizations do one of three things. Either the increased cost is picked up entirely by the organization or the company, employees amount, $30 a month, whatever stays fixed, which means their percent starts going down from 9% because it comes this way. Some companies got to the point where they're taking such huge costs, they said, listen, any cost that goes up, we're going to put that all on the employee. Or something in between. The third one would be, if the ratio is 91-9 right now, then the increased cost, if the board sets a policy and says, we'll equally share in that, so any increased cost, the county's budget will pick up some, and the employees would contribute more and keep that same ratio. We need a policy, this to be policy. Otherwise, every time we get to the budget, it hits the employees and it's difficult.
What is the ratios that Pat was giving us to comply with federal before it becomes a Cadillac plan and all that kind of stuff? We're not near it.
We're not increased.
We've got to, I think it's like 14%.
Yeah, and some of that relates to certain highly compensated employees as well. You have to be careful of the benefits you give them. We're all the same here.
If we continue to ignore that year after year, we're going to wake up and find ourselves in a budget year having to pass on a huge increase to the staff.
And if we do this at the same time, if we're able to do a wellness program and do this all at the same time, it might work together.
Because I'm not going to.
Why don't we get with Pat? Confirm what those numbers are and the dates that we need to hit them. And perhaps, as much as I don't want to, propose a schedule to the board of working towards getting there over the years on, and with the ultimate goal being, and so because if we don't get that ratio correct, they're going to be taxed on it, which is going to cost them more money in the long run.
Right.
So we need to get perhaps a plan put into place to work it there. We should have been doing it all along, but because of all of the other circumstances, we didn't. But if we're just going to find ourselves having to pass on go from 9% to 14% in 1 year, and that's going to really hurt people. So, the better we can do to put a plan into place, let the employees know that plan's in place, let them know why. It's not driven by not wanting to offer a benefits package, it's driven by federal law, and we got to get to that point.
We try to interpret that. So the goal would be perhaps a percentage
each year.
and then incrementally each year try to get to that percentage.
And I think a more sense.
Goal would be a percentage.
Well, that seems to be what we have to do. So it comes right in with you as a policy of percentage or ratios. That's, you know, that's where the feds are telling us we have to go. So we might as well adopt that philosophy and then work that ratio as painlessly as possible on the employees over whatever time we have till we got to get there.
And get it to be policy driven. So would you like us to start working with back a policy this year?
Needs to be planned. And staff needs to know that, you know, while this year, here's what the cost were, here's what the ratio was. Next year, here's what the projected cost will be, here's what the ratio is going to be, and that it's all based on claims. And, you know, if we educate people on what it is, it's not, oh, you guys are just trying to push more expense on us so that you can spend more money on your police cars or, you know, I mean, all those kind of comments, that it truly is driven by health care cost and the ratio that the federal government tells us to comply.
And a large part of the health care cost is not the price going up, it's the usage.
That's what I mean.
And that's why can effectively put in a very good wellness program. And that's where
you can't tell your people not to get sick, but they have to know that that's where the culture is.
But if we get in better shape and take some responsibility for our health, you know, the shape that we're in as far as health care is concerned.
We've talked about weight-driven programs and all kinds of things. And I believe in those because I believe in personal accountability. And if somebody's healthy, they shouldn't have to pay quite as much as people that are not healthy.
And maybe it'll work well if we can do this at about the same time, because to incentivize people to participate in the wellness program, it might be a two-tier type thing. If you do these things, we will not need to raise your contribution this high. Knowing that they go into the program within a fairly good period of time, if not the first year or the second year, the cost benefits will show. And that takes some of the profit.
And that goes directly to their pocket.
Right.
Because what we should do at that point is ensure that if those costs go down, that we don't keep it the same and use those savings somewhere else, that they get the benefit of those cost savings.
So we're working on policy. We'll keep looking, trying to work in the wellness program now. But we have to anticipate in the budget where it's going, because that program would not be adopted until third quarter.
How's the budget looking overall? You know, we had hoped, not officially, but I think several of us had hoped that there would be no increase, because there's not going to be a military increase. Right. And truly, we'd maybe like to see us maybe bring a little bit more in, a little bit tighter, maybe even cut a little bit.
So we're there yet?
Yeah. What are the
numbers?
Yes. Everything is still coming in.
Well,
so
I think it's important that everybody understand that there definitely is no increase.
Yeah, I think we're working under that assumption. There'll be no tax increase. And let me finish up. Any other healthcare input at all? Let me just relate to the area briefly for the budget, but it's a big area as far as we expand that to other personnel costs or benefits. As far as any input as far as anticipating wanting to see any merit raises, should we need to call on merit raises, or 401k is still 3%, we used to be at 5, I don't know if there's any interest in trying to restore that 5 for the employees or not.
I don't think so.
So probably that 3, is any input on that?
I just think it's a little too early to tell, in my opinion.
I wasn't saying yes or no, just want to ask.
No, I would like to see when budget requests are coming in.
Okay.
And if they're coming in with good reasonable numbers, okay, and we see that we're in, then we can look at, I would think, first COLAs or merit.
So
merit. And
so same thing, raise the info, okay, saying not yet, let's see where we're at.
And, you know, that's where the employees and their directors need to be very careful about what they're putting in their budget and what they're asking for, because there's no more dollars. The only way they're going to get merit is by reducing expenses. Solely, you know, and to me, that again goes back to that personal responsibility. It's really up to them whether they get it or not.
That's the main three areas we have for input. Anything else? So
I don't have it. You've covered everything. Unless y'all have some comments you want to talk
about. Appreciate all the hard work. Yeah. Appreciate the results.
And other than that was our main agenda. A was 2013 budget. Any other financial open discussion issues?
Not unless you know how you win a lot of it.
Well, it's interesting. They said when that big lot's out there for $500 million, they said the odds are 170 some million to one. If you covered all 170 million numbers, the only problem is it would take you like 8 years to physically do all that. I don't think you can get the tickets in time.
Yeah.
We need to formally adjourn, or we don't?
We are adjourned. Thank you.
We are done. Thank you.
Good night, Nydia.
Good night, Commissioner Tam.
They need that one of those.
All right. Under. Steel
plate. Our steel plate.
Yeah, any questions from you with clarification?
Did you get on
any of that?
I think so.
If you do, we'd rather you call than.
She does. She
okay.
Yeah,
I will. I know
you
will. I'm
kind
of fried right now. If I think of anything tomorrow,
I'll okay. All right. I thought she had written enough from the previous meeting. But
I'm not there. Making an act like me. I'm just telling
you. Good.
Well, yeah. We're all good. You get all that. That's just okay.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Good. There are ours anyway.
This is more. This is more. See you guys. Thank you for
See you. Thanks.
About the summary thing.
See you, Nydia.
Bye, Commissioner.